Hi all, Shane here, Landlad 67. Gonna be doing a bit of a painting tutorial, how to paint up American tank crew. This is gonna be for my Panzermeister Fall the Reich group build for my two Shermans. So this is gonna be a bit quicker because I kinda realized that people in the last tutorial kinda lost interest. So I'm gonna try to make this quick. So first thing we're gonna base coat the uniform, so we're going to use the German camo beige Vallejo. Okay, I think I have my paint a little bit too thin. So, I'm just going to add a little bit more paint to my cup. When you look, you'll be able to see this a bit better. I also relocated my compressor to the floor, so it's not going to be sounding like a bloody helicopter. And off to a flying start. Everything's going wrong. These models were primed in Vallejo Surface Primer Black. Some people have some bad experiences with this primer. I, for one, haven't. I know some of the earlier batches were a bit off, but it seems that Vallejo has rectified that problem. So give it a try before you bash it. So I think they might have fixed it. So, I keep knocking them over. So I just have them base coated, so what I'm going to do is we're going to let these dry and we'll be right back. So stay tuned and thank you for watching. Okay, so I left some time for this to set. I'll actually put one or two extra layers on top of the beige just to build it up a little bit. So we're going to continue. So now we're going to start painting in the flesh. This is similar to what I did for the Falchion tutorial. I know not many watched it because it was too long, so I'm going to kind of simplify it because these figures are a bit smaller. So I'm going to take my dark flesh, Vallejo dark flesh, mix a bit of water into my little palette. My palette's just underneath the camera so you can't see it, but it is there. So I'm just going to thin my paint slightly. Good thing about Vallejo is you can thin with water. Okay. Okay. And luckily there's not that much flesh to paint on these models, which is good. So. Painting the face, I'm sorry if the angle is a bit weird. I'm just trying to, the camera under my nose, I'm trying to maneuver it in a way that I can actually see what I'm doing. to be wearing Focus, wouldn't it? Yep. So same with this figure. They're wearing kind of gloves or mitts, so I want to paint them a different colour. Areas are painted in there. I'll use I'll keep coming back and building up layers of them because I don't want it too thick. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm going to paint in their gloves. So I'm going to base them with Citadel Base Avalon Sunset. It's a bit of a kind of mustardy yellow, and this is going to be my base, and then when I put the wash it's going to be toned down, and then I'm going to build it up with a kind of a canvas. So fuck it. This may seem a bit bright, but remember when we're putting washes down, which is how I shade my models, just like many other painters do, it's always good to be a few tones higher, because you're going to lose the intensity once you start putting darker washes down as well. So, let's focus on this one guy for now. Okay, because it's just gonna be too awkward, two figures and bumping off one another. And they're pretty much the same. The only difference is I'm gonna paint your man's trousers a bit different, because he doesn't really appear to be wearing the tanker's overalls. This fella is done. Okay. So, next part out, helmet. But this doesn't seem to be the standard tank helmet. It's more like almost like a rugby player's helmet. It's either that or it's the all-weather cap, which I actually think it's the all-weather cap, the campus all-weather cap, so I'm going to paint it up as such. So we're going to use Citadel Death Force, Death World Forest, it's a base colour. It's a nice kind of canvasy colour. Kind of like it's a good drab colour to use, so we'll coat it in that. I'm going to paint that completely the wrong colour, but I will check that line as well for reference material for this hat, and I couldn't find a bloody thing. The closest thing I could find was the all-weather caps. Kind of like the bonnet that the lads wore. So I'm going to say it's one of those, or a modified one of them. Before Europe, the Irish kind and Gary Adams, So we're taking care to be neat with our paintwork. So in one area is drying, we're working on the other. Okay. Now. So, what's next? Well, I want to paint in the holster. He's wearing one of those neat shoulder holsters. So we're going to switch to a pretty fine brush. If I can find the brush, I'll be doing bloody well. So I'm going to be using a MIG Octolong 4-0. Great brushes. And what I use for leather is Vallejo Surface Primer Rock Brown. Or Red Brown, German Red Brown. It's really good, kind of, I find a very good base for any kind of leather. So, we'll start here at the back of the shoulder brace. Now this might take a couple layers and we'll build it up as well, highlighting it, but I just find this is a very good colour to base leather. There we go. And then just strap over his shoulder. And all we'll do is we'll go back, make sure we're in focus, and we'll block in again the flesh, just give another layer, because it's still a bit uneven. So that's normally what the trick is, just to keep working on the various parts of the figure while other parts are drying. So backing with the bark flesh. There you go, nice and... There we go. So I'll paint in these goggles. So I think I'm going to do them again in the same kind of leather colour. Or at least the strap's going to be done in the same leather. So I got my little detail brush. Okay, so now the actual goggles themselves will be painted in German grey. Okay, the figure is blocked in, but for the side arm, which I'm going to pick out in gunmetal, and I'm going to pause now, so I'm just going to pick out the pistol in gunmetal, and I'm going to let this dry for a few minutes, and then I'm going to put the wash down and begin highlights, and then finally we'll put the markings for first armor division, and that'll be him done. And then we'll move on to the other figure, which is going to be done in exactly the same way. Painted, the only difference is I might do these trousers in a different colour, just to add a bit of difference to them. So catch. Hell yeah, now we're going to start adding washes to add our shading. So I have a few different washes made up here in my palette. For the uniform, so the beige areas, we're going to be using an oil wash. It's about maybe 20% oil to about 80% thinner, and I've mixed burnt sienna and burnt umber to darken it slightly, and I'm going to apply that to the uniform areas. Sorry, keep bumping the camera. Just add a kind of slight red hue to it. Doesn't want to be too heavy. So I'm going to be adding other washes to build up various effects. Because washes basically can change the entire hue of the model. Now I'm going to switch brushes. So I'm using oil and acrylic paints. Not mixed together. On my palette, so I have, in one pot I have oils and in one I have acrylics. Be careful not to mix them together and do not use the same brush. So now I'm going to switch to burnt sienna acrylic. You can use both if you wanted to, as in you could either use acrylic or oil. I'm experimenting with both. Again, they are not mixed together. I'm using different brushes to apply them. So I'm going to start shadowing the skin. Sorry, this is a bit awkward to have the camera set up and kind of snookering myself. There we go. Again, into the crevices we want. There we go. A little bit. I'm going to add another wash on top of the burnt sienna on the uniform. It's going to be a bit of a darker wash, just to create some different tones and see. Just, you know, it's always a good experiment. Then for the helmet and for the gloves, I'm going to add army color dark tone wash, which is an ink wash. So that's going to go up here. Business gloves. For some reason this doesn't want to take, which is a bit unusual. So clean my brush and try to apply again. Yeah, it's kind of unusual. I hasn't done that before. Get a good shake. Let's see, can we fix this? Bully dog pining next door in the States across the way. They have a dog which they never really bother to give attention to, so he spends most of the day pining. Don't understand why people buy like animals and they don't bother their arses with them. Kind of defeats the purpose. Okay. So that's the first layer of washing done. We'll let that dry and we'll be back. And I'm going to try to see what the hell's going on with this army painter wash. It doesn't want to do anything. So if it comes down to it, I'll actually apply what I'm going to have to do anyway when it comes to applying the decals. I have markings for this chap. So if it comes down to it, I'm just going to gloss coat the entire thing and try to put the ink wash over it and we'll see what happens. So catch you in a few. Hey y'all, so we're back again, and I've just allowed the wash to set. I built up the wash a few layers until I was happy with it off camera, just as it was drying, and then I stuck in front of the heater under supervision. So now I'm going to start doing highlights. I'm going to start with the flesh. So we're going to highlight the nose, jaw lines, and cheeks with sunny flesh tone, getting filet-o. No, that's a bit much. So I'm going to try to keep an eye on the time on this. I want to get this under 30 minutes if I can. I don't want to lose people by making overly long tutorial videos. So it's the cheeks, the brow, and the chin. So if you have too much paint on your brush, just remove it onto your thumb. I'm sorry now, I'm just trying to maneuver this chap so I can see what I'm doing. Nice and simple. This type of scale of figure, you don't have to go too crazy with highlighting the face. Just a basic highlight. And this works well with 35th scale figures as well. Instead of like the overly complex way I did it with the Fultrum Troopin. This is simply a base, a wash, and a highlight. And you get that, you get a pretty nice effect. There we go. And then if you go in too strong, you can always just apply a thin glaze to bring the shadow back into the model. Okay, that's the face. I'm happy with that. No point doing the eyes either, because the shadow will do that. So what we'll do now is we'll do his uniform. So what we'll do is, we'll just basically use the base colour, which is German camo beige, and we'll continue with that. So stay tuned for that, I can switch out my memory. Okay, and you're back. So it's going to take my German camo beige. May not be necessary to mix anything to it yet, we'll see. Now we'll just begin to highlight the model. So it's around the back where you can most easily see. So I'm going to do back of the collar, any raised areas, okay, just thin my paint slightly. There we go. Sorry about that, I need to my paint. So, like that. So bear in mind too, if you look at pictures of US kind of uniforms, they're not overly bright. They almost have a dusty appearance. So I would describe it. So I'm not going to go too insane with highlights. Just in key areas. And it's going to be exactly the same for the standing figure. So anyone's wondering why I'm not showing the other figure, it's because I'm going to be doing the exact same method. No, it's only a point showing it twice. This kind of trick is to take your time, keep your paint reasonably tinned. I'm not going to give you like an estimate how tinned you want it. It's more personal preference, more so just enough so you can work easily with it. The nice thing about working this scale is it's a nice quick work time, you know, it's not. These aren't too kind of labor intensive, these type of models. Again, up here. Do you want to take just blend? But it was working it in. No. So we're almost there now. There's a bit of highlighting here. Okay, so that's the his uniform, kind of how I like it. I might put a small little glaze over this when everything's done. And now what we're going to do is we're going to highlight these gloves, and we're back to the base colour, which again is Avalon Sunset. And we're just going to do the knuckles. Again, I don't want to make the highlights too strong on the gloves. I want them to kind of have almost like a grimy appearance, but just to. Then for his holster, for the leather of the holster, where is my red leather? Just a second, we'll track down this. Okay, so I'm going to highlight the letter areas with Vallejo red letter. Again, tinged with a little bit of water. Okay, you guys can see, I'm sorry again for the angle, but again it's always good to manipulate the model to I'm only kind of doing spot highlighting here, just kind of to accentuate the letter. Okay, and I'm going to do the same to the band of his girdles. Also, now that I think about it, the glass on these girdles were painted in Citadel Dark Reaper. Just in case, I just thought of that there. A bit too heavy there, but again, not to worry. By just dampening our brush, we can kind of wet blend in. There we go. So. And then finally, we'll do highlights on the top of his hat. Again, using the base color of Dead World Forest. And we're going to do the leading edges, leaving. Almost can't even notice. Okay. And there you have them. All that's left to do now is to So all left now is to add a little layer of gloss varnish so I can add his markings. And that'll be it. So that's only a part of the painting guide, and I hope this was a little bit useful. But not to worry, I said many of you are getting sick of all this wargaming stuff. I have an immediate update on my F-18 Hobby Boss 1/48 scale Hornet, which should be being uploaded around the same time as this video. So so not to worry, I'm not forgetting the rest of you model makers either. So thanks for watching, I hope this was interesting, and I'll catch you all in the next one. Bye bye.